गेट 2000 क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। गेट 2010 ट्यूमर्स क्वेश्चन। फॉर टूल ए द टेलर्स टूल लाइफ कोएफिशिएंट, टेलर्स टूल लाइफ कोएफिशिएंट इज 0.45 एंड कांस्टेंट इज 90। सो टूल ए, सो टेलर टूल लाइफ कोएफिशिएंट, टेलर टूल लाइफ कोएफिशिएंट इक्वल टू व्हाट इज द टेलर टूल सी वी टी पावर एन इक्वल टू कांस्टेंट एन, एन इज द टेलर टूल लाइफ कोएफिशिएंट इक्वल टू 0.45। टेलर्स constant equal to c equal to 90. Similarly for tool b, n is equal to 0.3 and c tool b that constant is equal to 60. The cutting speed above which tool A will have higher tool life than tool B. So tool life of A is greater than or equal to tool B. The cutting speed above which the tool life of A will have higher tool life than tool B. Vt power n equal to constant. So t equal to c by v whole power 1 by n. So ta is greater than equal to tb, right? Substitute in equation 1. So c a by v, you need to calculate the velocity, cutting speed in meter per minute, mm. So you need to calculate the cutting speed at which the tool A will have the tool life greater than or equal to B. So you take the condition of equal to instead of greater than and substitute VA equal to tool B. The cutting speed of both will be the same. C by V whole power NA equal to C by V whole power 1 by n a equal to 1 by n b. Substitute here, find the velocity, and instead of that you can do one method. So you know c a, c a is how much? 90 by v whole power 1 by 0.45 equal to 60 by v 1 by 0.3. okay, so you have options A 26.7, B 42.5, C 80.7, D 142.9. Substitute the value of V into the equation and whichever satisfies the equation is the answer. So this is one of the method to save the time, especially on calculations, because you know here you need to take if the any mistake is there, you know, because the powers of velocity also will be there, so there is a high chance of doing mistake. So to avoid that, you can go by substitution method. So after substituting, V equal to answer is 26.7 is satisfies answer. So answer for the above question is 26A. Simple question, but only thing is you have to be careful. Question number 2. Friction at the tool chip interface can be reduced by options. friction at the tool chip interface can be reduced by decreasing the rake angle. A. Option B is increasing the depth of cut. Option C is decreasing the cutting speed. Option D is increasing the cutting speed. So if you decrease the rake angle, what happens? Friction increases because contact area increases. Increase the depth of cut. Depth of cut increases the thickness of the chip and bending of the chip. So it friction increases. Decreasing the cutting speed. If you decrease the cutting speed, it had lot of time to come in contact. So its friction will be. So answer is D. Question number 2. Gate 2009. So friction at the tool chip interface can be reduced by friction at tool chip interface can be reduced by option is increasing the cutting speed. Answer is D. Question number 5 and 6, linked answer question, gate 2009, 4 marks question. So he has given, in a machining experiment, tool life was found to vary with the cutting speed in the following manner. He has given table, cutting speed, meter per minute, and tool life, minutes. So 60, 90, 81, 36. So cutting speed and tool life. For question number 5, the exponent n and constant c of the Taylor's tool life equation are. So answer A is n equal to 0.5 and k equal to 540. B is n equal to 1 and k equal to 4860. C is n equal to minus 1 and k equal to 0.74. D is n equal to minus 0.5 and k equal to 1.155. So Taylor's exponent. Here, how to solve this problem? Two more question, and next question is connected, linked to this. So you want to find n and c. So v t power n equal to constant. This is the equation. V1 T1 power n equal to constant. V2 T2 power n equal to constant. So equating this, V1 T1 power n equal to V2 T2 power n. So substituting V2 by V1 equal to T1 by T2 whole power n. Take log on both sides, log of base e v2 by v1 equal to n log base e t1 by t2. So n equal to log of v2 by v1 by t1 by t2 log a by log b, log a minus log b. Simplify this, you will get n value. This is, and you substitute this n in the vt power n equal to constant, So n, after simplifying this, the n value is, n value, what is fifth question, right? The n value is 0.5. Substitute this 0.5, v1 t1 power 0.5 equal to constant. Then calculate c equal to, or c or k, both he has mentioned k in answer, equal to 540. So this is one method. Instead of this, you can do another way. How we can do is substitute. So take the vt power n equal to constant one equation, or substitution method. Substitute 60 into 81 power n equal to k. Substitute this n value, and whichever equation equates to k, that is the answer. This is one of the easiest method, substitution, for especially this problem, because there is log simplification you may do wrong, and so that's one best way to go is substitution method. Question number 6. So what is the percentage increase in tool life when the cutting speed of option A is 50%, option B is 200%, option C is 300%, option D is 400%. So what is the percentage increase in the tool life when the cutting speed is halved? So we have the equation of Vt power 0.5 equal to 540. So he is asking V1 T1 power 0.5 equal to V2 T2 power 0.5. So percentage increase in tool life. So V1 by V2 equal to T2 by T1 whole power 0.5. 0.5 is nothing but square root. So T2 by T1 equal to, if you come 10, send the square root this side, it will become square. V1 by V2 whole square. So T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2. So when the cutting speed, V2 equal to V1 by 2 whole square. So V2 equal to V1 by 2. V2 equal to V1 by 2 whole square. So substitute T2 equal to T1 into 2 power square 4. So T2 equal to 4T1. So percentage increase in tool life, that means T2 minus T1 by T1 into 100 is equal to, T2 is nothing but 4T1 minus T1 by T1 into 100. 4T1 minus T1, 3T1 by T1 into 100 is equal to 300% increase. So answer is C. So this is one of the good problem. I mean, there is nothing logical, but second part is little bit, you know, people go for 400% directly or 200%. So this is one method where, you know, we can trap. Question number 7. Gate 2009 again. So internal gear cutting operation can be performed by, option A is milling, option B is shaping with rack cutter, option C is shaping with pinion cutter, Option D is hobbing. So here internal gear cutting, generally in external gear cutting is milling, internal gear cutting is shaping with pinion cutter, performed by shaping with pinion cutter. Answer C. Question number 12 and 13. Here we need to use our old formula. Question number 12 and 13 is again linked answer question, 4 marks. He has asked in 2008. Question number 12 and 13. ME 2008. So orthogonal turning is performed on a cylindrical workpiece with the shear strength of 250 MPa. The following conditions are used. Cutting velocity VC equal to 180 meter per minute. Feed equal to F equal to 0.2 mm per revolution. Depth of cut D equal to 3 mm. Chip thickness ratio. Follow one notation such that you won't confuse. R, chip thickness ratio is nothing but R equal to 0.5. Orthogonal rake angle. So rake angle is nothing but alpha equal to 7 degrees. Apply Merchant's theory. Apply Merchant's theory and shear strength tau equal to 250 megapascal. First question is the shear plane angle and the shear force respectively are. The shear plane angle and the shear force are. A is 52 Newton. And 320 Newton. Option B is 52 Newton and 400 Newton. Option C is 320 Newton this one. 28,400 Newton. So D is 28,320 Newton. So how we have to first shear plane angle? We know that there is one formula, tan pi equal to R cos alpha by 1 minus R sin alpha. Right? So we have, he has given R is nothing but chip thickness ratio 0.5 cos 7 divided by 1 minus 0.5 sin 7. Substitute this value, pi equal to tan inverse of 0.5 cos 7 by 1 minus 0.5 sin 7. So angle, the value, then shear angle, whatever you will get here, it is a shear angle is 28 degrees. So if you know the shear angle, you can eliminate two options. Now you need to calculate shear force. Now shear force equal to shear stress into shear area. Shear area is nothing but normal area into normal area by sin pi. We know that this is shear area, this is normal area, this is pi. So sin pi equal to a naught by as. So as equal to a naught by sin pi. So tau we has given 250 MPa into a naught is nothing but here he has not given uncut chip thickness or width. So what we can take is a naught is equal to, if you observe the diagram of turning, suppose this is a shaft, right? In turning the tool is, it is a tool, so it is moving. Depth of cut is nothing but uncut chip thickness. So d equal to t1 and b is nothing but feed, width is nothing but feed here. So feed into depth of cut divided by sin pi. So 250 shear force equal to 250 into feed is how much, 0.2 into 3 divided by sin pi. Substitute the value, the answer shear force you will get is 320 Newton approximately. So answer is D. Next question is cutting force in the same linked answer question. It is 4 marks question. The cutting force and the frictional force respectively are. So we know that shear force. So next question is 13th question is the cutting force and frictional force. Respectively, A is 568 Newton, 387 Newton. B is 565 Newton, 381 Newton. C is 440 Newton, 342 Newton. D is 480 Newton, 356 Newton. So we know shear force, we need to find cutting force and frictional force. So there is one relation. So 2 pi Mersenne theory, 2 pi plus beta minus alpha equal to 90. Substitute here pi equal to 27. Calculate the beta value. Beta equal to, the value you will get is 41 degrees. Substituting this alpha we have given 7. So now cutting force and thrust force, cutting force and shear force, there is one relation. If you remember or not, draw the Mersenne circle if you didn't remember. So this is Fs and this is cutting force, thrust force, frictional force, and this one is beta, 90 minus beta, and this is beta minus alpha, and this is pi. And this one is resultant force. So we need to have relation between cutting force and thrust force. Cos pi equal to shear force by R. So R equal to Fs by cos pi. Similarly, so cos beta minus alpha equal to Fc by R. So R equal to Fc by cos beta minus alpha. So substitute equate R Fs by cos pi. So cos beta minus alpha, we know the beta, we know alpha, we know pi. Substitute Fc equal to Fs into cos beta minus alpha divided by cos pi. So if you substitute the values, we know the shear force. So cutting force is nothing but, we need to calculate cutting force only, right? Yeah. So cutting force is 381 newton. So next, frictional force. Similarly, frictional force, relation between frictional forces, so same, cos 90 minus beta equal to adjacent side F by R, R equal to F by sin beta, that is nothing but Fs by cos pi. Substitute F equal to Fs into cos pi, sorry, Fs into sin beta divided by cos pi. So substituting, you will get the value of 447 newton. So answer for this problem is B, 13th one. So only thing is, you need to remember the Mohr circle diagram, then you can derive the formula then and there itself without remembering. So better know the concept, you can derive the formula. Otherwise, if you remember the formula by heart it, then it will be difficult, because you need to remember lot of things. So better to understand the concept, please repeat. This is very important, especially this Mohr circle concept. So practice the things more times such that you will remember. So little correction here. So this is not cos pi. So here this is cos pi minus beta plus cos pi plus beta minus alpha. Please correct it. So here cos pi plus beta minus alpha. Cos pi plus beta minus alpha equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. So everywhere you need to substitute cos pi plus beta minus alpha. 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 Substitute it. So because here this is a pi value and this one is beta minus alpha, you need to sum these two angles, then only the triangle will form. So question number 3, gate 2009, 2 marks question. Minimum shear strain in orthogonal cutting tool of 0 rake angle is 0, B 0.5, C 1, D 2. This is one of the good question. So minimum shear strain in orthogonal cutting of 0 rake angle. So given alpha equal to 0 rake angle and minimum shear strain, he is asking. So for minimum shear strain condition, for minimum shear strain condition, two pi minus alpha equal to 90. So alpha is 0, alpha is 0, then pi equal to 45. The shear strain equal to, we know the formula for shear strain, cot pi plus tan pi minus alpha. This you need to remember. So cot of 45 plus tan of 45 minus 0, nothing but 1 plus 1, 2. Answer is D. One of the best questions. So next question is question number 33. In an orthogonal cutting test on mild steel, the following data is obtained. So he has given cutting speed equal to 40 meter per minute and depth of cut equal to 0.3 mm and tool rake angle equal to 5 degrees and chip thickness is T2 equal to 1.5, cutting force equal to 900 newton, thrust force equal to 450 newton. Using Merchant's analysis, the friction angle during the machining will be, using Merchant's analysis, the friction angle. So first question is friction angle. Friction angle is nothing but beta dash. So to get the friction angle, what you need to do? Merchant circuit 2 pi plus beta minus alpha equal to 90 based on Merchant's. So we want to find beta, we know alpha, we need to find pi also. Tan pi equal to r cos alpha by 1 minus r sin alpha. Will it help here? Chip thickness he has given. So chip thickness he has given. We need to find the uncut chip thickness. So uncut chip thickness is nothing but 0.3. So 0.3 by 0.3 by the value, the uncut chip thickness. This is one method. R equal to D by T2 equal to 0.3 by 1.5. So substitute r and alpha, you will get pi value. Substitute the pi value in here and then the value whatever you will get is a beta, the friction angle. This is one method. Another method is the friction angle of substituting, you will get 31.5. So another method is based on Merchant circle, tan beta minus alpha equal to ft by fc. What is ft? 450, fc 900. So simplifying 1/2. So alpha we know, beta minus alpha equal to tan inverse 1/2. So beta equal to alpha plus tan inverse 1/2. Simple. There are different methods, but whatever the method you use, you will get the same answer. Approach may be different. Next, it is a linked answer question. In the same question, in a machining operation, the doubling the cutting speed reduces the tool life to 1/8 original value. The exponent n in the Taylor's coefficient. 34 question. ME 2004. In a machining, doubling the cutting speed, so that means V2 equal to 2V1, reduces the tool life T2 equal to T1/8. The exponent in Taylor's tool life equation is, so n equal to dash. So V1 T1 power n equal to V2 T2 power n. V1 by V2 equal to T2 by T1 whole power n. So substitute the values whatever he has given. V1 by 2V1, V2 equal to V1. So T2 equal to T1 by 8 by T1 whole power n. So V1 cancel, 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 8 whole power n. So n equal to get n, take log of 1 by 2 equal to n log of 1 by 8. 1 by 8 is nothing but 1 by 2 whole power 3. N equal to log of 1 by 2 divided by log of 1 by 8 equal to log 1 by 2 divided by log 1 by 2 whole cube. So equal to 1 by 3 log of 1 by 2 divided by log of 1 by 2 cancel, equal to 1 by 3 is answer. Simple answer for this problem is C. So we do some one problem in conventional non-conventional machining. So arrange the process in the increasing order of their maximum material removal rate. So material removal rate is maximum in which of the following? Question number 22, gate 2006, 2 marks question. Increasing order of material removal rate. So increasing order, he has given ultrasonic machining, laser beam machining, electron beam machining, electric discharge machining, electrochemical machining. Material removal rate is minimum in laser beam machining. Their material removal rate is minimum. So that one, if you know that, then you can eliminate two options. And material removal rate is more in out of this electrochemical machining. So the order is laser beam machining is material removal rate is less, electron beam machining, next is your ultrasonic machining, next is electric discharge machining, next is electrochemical machining. Next question is question number 31, gate 2004. The mechanism of material removal rate in IDM electric discharge machining is mechanism of material removal in EDM process is, EDM is nothing but electric discharge machining. In electric discharge machining, what we have to remember is the spark will generate between anode and cathode. Because of the spark, heat will produce, because of heat, workpiece will get melt and evaporate. So mechanism is melting and evaporation. So answer is A. So he has given melting and evaporation A. B is melting and corrosion, that is not correct. Erosion and cavitation, not correct. Cavitation and evaporation. So answer is A.